Thank you, Javier. In my part of the presentation, I walk you through the main aspects of the neural network design process for SOC estimation. The main aspects include an overview of the training, validation, and testing process, the neural network model structure, data preparation, an approach to improve robustness of the model, and finally, some SOC estimation results at multiple temperature, including negative 10 degrees Celsius. Let's go.
A simplified concept of feed-forward neural network is shown in Figure 1, and a flowchart of each training process is shown in Figure 2. First, the initial value of the learnable parameters, weights and bias, are randomly assigned using, in our case, an orthogonal distribution. Secondly, a so-called forward propagation computes the initial output, the SOC candidate, and then compares to a reference SOC to compute the loss for this iteration. The loss is then backpropagated using a series of partial derivatives with respect to each of the neural network weights and bias, updating their values, and then repeating the forward propagation plus the backpropagation steps. This iterative process continues until meeting predetermined criteria, such as reaching a particular accuracy or reaching a certain number of iterations. Another step happens at the regular intervals during the training process, where a separate dataset, the test or validation dataset, is fed into the model candidate to validate the accuracy of the FNN during the training process using forward propagation step without changing any of the learnable parameters. Before the training process, the data preparation is a very important step. It's necessary to check and clean the data as well normalize its vector to improve training and accuracy of the model. Normalization is a very common procedure when training a neural network. The type of neural network we are talking about in this seminar is the feed-forward neural network, or just FNN. However, different machine learning approaches can be used for this purpose. For example, recurrent neural networks such as LSTM. The input for this FNN are the temperature, voltage, and current from the battery. Although, a very important aspect that I would like to remark is the moving average filters. Unlike recurrent neural network, FNN doesn't consider past information to help make its estimation. Just for comparison, without the filter, the estimation error is 3 or 5 times higher. In the next slide, we'll show how we have selected the number of neurons for the hidden layers. In order to select the number of neurons for our model, we have trained 100 models by varying the number of neurons in its hidden layers, as shown in Figure 7. The training parameters used in this selection is shown here. Although, based on these results, the models with 55, 82, and 99 neurons presented very similar accuracy, which we'll discuss in the next slide. In Figure 6, shows the results of 2,000 trained models, and despite the significant variation of number of neurons, many results are very similar. This is because the random initial seed values assigned to each of the weights and bias every time a training process starts, which can lead to different local minima, even for the same number of neurons and structure. Therefore, the number of neurons for the neural network structure in this work was chosen to be 55, which is the lowest number of neurons among the 3 best results we could find. In the next slide, we will show more details about the final FNN structure and some results. The detailed final FNN structure and the LGHG2 lithium ion SOC estimation at 25 degrees Celsius result is shown in Figure 8. The activation functions used in this structure are the hyperbolic tangent, leaky ReLU at 0.03, and clip ReLU at 1. This model presents a very good accuracy on the SOC estimation, close to 0.5% on the mean absolute error. On the next slide, we'll show how this model can be visualized in the MATLAB Deep Network app. One way to visualize the neural network structure that we've been discussing in the MATLAB is going through the apps, Deep Neural Network Designer. Then you can actually import the model and open up in this app, and then you can see how many activations, learnables, and what kind of structure it is. And this is how it shows in how it is shown in the MATLAB. This is really interesting if you want to have to visualize quickly the structure you just built in the MATLAB. And it also can use to build your own structure also this way.
In the case of SOC estimation for electrified vehicles, the sensor used to capture voltage, current, and temperature have significant error. Due to the low-cost sensor models you typically use in the automotive industry. If the expected error is known during the model design, the neural network training dataset can be augmented to include error on the signal, improving the robustness of the resulting model. Here, Table 5 shows the gain and offset values used to augment the dataset for each input feature.
The figure 9 here shows that despite the inclusion of the noise in the test dataset following the 14 cases in Table 4 discussed previously, the SOC estimation was maintained with similar value throughout all cases. By using the final structure that we have been discussing, a FNN-based model was trained on a dataset containing multiple temperatures, including negative 10 degrees Celsius. As shown in this figure 11, the model performed incredibly well in all temperatures. Even though at negative temperature, the SOC estimation becomes considerably more challenging to be estimated, and it performed considerably well even at such difficult condition. Here in Table 6 show a summary of the results, where the RMS error was kept close to 1.2% in all temperature cases and under 1% on the mean absolute error. To quick summarize this part of the seminar, we have shown an overview of the FNN training process, part of the design process of the FNN for electrified vehicle battery SOC estimation, data preparation for a lithium-ion LG-HG2. We have presented an approach to improve the SOC estimation robustness. And finally, we have presented and discussed the results when the model was exposed to multiple temperatures, including negative temperatures. Thank you.